Hello and welcome to Alicia's medical classes. So today's topic is amino acid classification. So amino acids are divided into four groups, like based on four things. Number one is based on structure. Number two is based on side chain. Number three is based on nutritional requirement. And number four is depending on the metabolism. So now we'll see each in detail. So when we are talking about the structure, we are talking about the how the amino acid looks. Like, is it aliphatic? Is it aromatic? Is it made up of any ring? Is it made up of any other group? So we have five categories. Number one is aliphatic amino acid. So for reference, I have used Vasudevan Biochemistry by D.M. Vasudevan. So if you want to refer the same, please refer Vasudevan book, which is a very good book, and in detail description is given, and I have prepared this chart from the same. So now coming to aliphatic amino acid, there are three types of aliphatic amino acid. So number one, where monoamino monocarboxylic, that means there's one amino group and there's one COOH group, that is carboxylic group. And coming on next to monoamino dicarboxylic, there is one amino and dicarboxylic, means there are two carboxylic groups. Dibasic monocarboxylic, so there is two amino and one carboxylic acid. So now when we talk of monoamino, there are five categories into it: simple amino acid, branch chain, hydroxy amino acid, sulfur containing amino acid, and amide containing amino acid. So now when we talk of simple amino acid, we know that lysine and alanine are the simplest of all the amino acid. Now branch chained amino acid, there is a trick to remember that, that is VIL, will, so valine, isoleucine, and leucine. When we talk of hydroxy amino acid, we mean here that the amino acid has hydroxyl group, that is OH group. So we have to remember OST or O tisari. So OST, that is serine and threonine. Now sulfur containing amino acids are very easy. Methionine and cysteine we have been learning in 11th and 12th classes. Amide containing amino acid. Now we know that acidic amino acid are aspartic acid and glutamic acid. So from that we have to remember here aspargine and glutamine. So aspargine and glutamine, this is also can be remembered as AG, as a mnemonic. Aliphatic amino acid has the other group, monoamino dicarboxylic acid, jo second group hai, which has one amino and two carboxylic group. Usme aata aspartic acid and glutamic acid. They are acidic amino acids. Now coming to dibasic monocarboxylic, that is two amino group and one COOH group, that makes it basic amino acid. The examples of that is lysine and arginine. There's also histidine, which is a basic amino acid, but it is not added here because it is a heterocyclic type of amino acid. Now coming on to aromatic, number two aromatic amino acid, it has phenylalanine and tyrosine. Heterocyclic amino acid, as I said, heterocyclic amino acid is remembered as H-histine and heterocyclic. This is also aromatic, but it has heterocyclic, means more than, there are different cyclic structures present over here. Tryptophan and histidine. Amino acid containing amino acid is proline. And number five categories, derived. In derived we have three categories: found in proteins, found derived amino acid which is not seen in proteins, and non-alpha amino acid. Found in proteins, hydroxyproline and hydroxylysine, which are the important component of collagen, and gamma carboxylation of glutamic acid residues is important for clotting. Now derived amino acid which are not seen in proteins. And this derived amino acids is seen in free cells, for example ornithine, citrulline, homocysteine. And also thyroxine is derived from tyrosine in some cases. Non-alpha amino acids are GABA and beta-alanine. GABA and beta-alanine. GABA is gamma amino butyric acid, which is a derivative of glutamic acid. And beta-alanine is constituent of pantothenic acid, which is a vitamin, and coenzyme A. This beta alanine, where amino group is in the beta position, therefore we refer it as beta alanine. Amino group is at the beta position. Now coming on to based on side chain, the second type of classification of amino acid is based on side chain. Now when we talk of based on side chain, we have polar and non-polar type of amino acid. Now, in polar amino acid, we have charged or ionic or hydrophilic. Now, when we are talking about charge, it can be positive or negative charge. If positive charge is present on the amino acid, it is acidic amino acid for short. So, when we talk of acidic amino acid, again, the example comes aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Now, tyrosine is also mildly acidic, which is given here. So we have to remember that also. Now, negative charge amino acid is basic amino acid. It has histidine, arginine and lysine as mentioned earlier, which is a type of dibasic monocarboxylic amino acid. Now, we have dealt with the charged part of the polar side chain. Now, when polar side chain has uncharged or non-ionic side chain, so let's deal with that. It has, for example, it has glycine, serine, threonine, aspargine, glutamine, cysteine, and tyrosine. You can make any type of mnemonic for this and you can remember this. Tyrosine, as I mentioned, it may be mildly acidic, so it is also considered as positive, and sometimes it is uncharged, it's considered as uncharged non-ionic polar type of side chain amino acid. So it is also included in uncharged. Otherwise, it has glycine, serine, threonine, aspargine, glutamine and cysteine. It is also type of a hydrophilic type. It is water loving. Tyrosine and cysteine may show hydrophobic when present in interior of protein. Whenever tyrosine and cysteine are present in interior of the protein, they convert into hydrophobic. That is, they are water hating and they behave as a lipophilic substances, that is lipid loving. Now, non-polar type of side chain if present in amino acid, such amino acids are alanine, valine, leucine, isoleucine, methionine, proline, tryptophan and phenylalanine. The type of hydrophobic or lipophilic. Hydrophobic is water hating and lipophilic is lipid loving. Now, therefore, the parts of the proteins which are made up of this amino acid, it are hydrophobic in nature. Now, coming on to the third type of classification, that is based on nutritional requirement. Now, based on nutritional requirement, we know that essential and non-essential type of amino acids are present. Now, to remember the essential type of amino acid, we have a mnemonic, that is met will fly. Met will fly. We have seen the will for amino acid classification that was based on branched chain, so VIL. For that also we have used will, and you could also use will here so that it would be easy for you to remember. So MAT will fly. So Y is for nothing, MAT, MATT. So methionine, arginine, tryptophan, threonine, valine, isoleucine, leucine, phenylalanine, histidine and lysine. Now I have marked two amino acids with red color here. So the one is arginine and other is histidine. So this is considered as semi-essential. Now, what makes it essential and what makes it semi-essential? Now, essential is their carbon skeleton cannot be synthesized by the human. So they are needed in the diet for normal growth. But when we talk of semi-essential, they are needed only in growing children in diet. But in adults, they are not considered as essential. So they are termed as semi-essential. The examples are histidine and arginine. Now, non-essential, other remaining 10 amino acids are non-essential. They can be synthesized in the body, though non-essential amino acids are also needed for the body for protein synthesis. All the body proteins contain all the types of non-essential amino acid, but it can be synthesized in the body, so they are termed as non-essential, which we cannot take from diet or which we don't require from the diet, so it is non-essential. Now, the fourth type of amino acid is depending on the metabolism. So, if the lipid undergoes metabolism, if it produces or it is converted into ketone bodies, this term is purely ketogenic. And if it undergoes into the glucogenic pathway, it is termed as purely glucogenic. If it undergoes both, it can be ketogenic and glucogenic both. Now, in purely ketogenic, we have an example, leucine and lysine. Lysine in humans is purely ketogenic, but lysine in other animals, it is both ketogenic and glucogenic. So here we are considering leucine and lysine, but first priority we give to leucine if it is in MCQ. So leucine is purely ketogenic and lysine is also purely ketogenic. It is converted into ketone bodies. Now, purely glucogenic, all the examples except this five, that is leucine, phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan, isoleucine and lysine. So all the other 14 remaining amino acids, now we have dealt here with the 6 amino acids, that is leucine, phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan, isoleucine and lysine. So other than that are into the glucogenic pathway. Now phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan, isoleucine, lysine, they are ketogenic and glucogenic both, and lysine in other animals is considered as both ketogenic and glucogenic, but in humans it is purely ketogenic. So here ends our classification of amino acids. Thank you for listening.